Are actually comprising all what we are discussing today, how agriculture was not in a faraway past, but actually 30, 40 years ago, and what agriculture is today, and even more what it will be in the future. Thank you very much for the overview, and for addressing not only the usefulness of open data, but also the problems that are related to open data, and also bringing in the consumer and the producer, you, and finally, I believe what you have shown with the problems in your conclusion slide should be among the things we are going to discuss today, which is actually how to make the data, and in particular the agri-food data, findable, interoperable, and searchable, and accessible, of course. So our next speaker is Teresa Lazzaro. Teresa is from Scuola Sant'Anna in Pisa. She is a project partner in Capsella, and she has a difficult job to work and to run one of our pilots where we combine open data with local data coming from local communities. And we produce an ICT application that will be used by these communities in order to monitor their soil. So Teresa will combine the user perspective, the data provider perspective, but also the ICT and research perspective.
I'm very happy to have the possibility to contribute to the dialogue on open science at this fair with a case from agriculture, actually a case from a very peculiar subdomain of agriculture system. Open data, when it's coupled with appropriate data infrastructure, and when on that we are able to build tailored ICT tools for the stakeholders in the sector, are very useful, and there will be more and more useful to build the future of agriculture. Agriculture in general, but also to help that part of stakeholders in the agricultural world which are working daily for the sustainability of the food production. And if we look to the how the Open Data Institute in its position paper from 2015 on open data in agriculture, following what there was summarized from the previous experiences with open data in agriculture, we see that the open data initiatives in agriculture work best when the initiatives are done with a strong cooperation with the stakeholders, and when the data are used based on real-world problems, so not getting the data and saying, what do I do with this large amount of data I have, but starting really from the issue from the ground, let's say. I will describe the experience that we are having with supporting open data-driven participatory innovation in the agriculture sector in the context of the project Capsella. This project is a collective awareness platform, as many others founded by the European Union, for building a fertile environment for social digital innovation. In our case, this is digital innovation in the area of agriculture. What we are trying to do is to integrate open science and open data with the experimental results and especially with a local knowledge, with farmers' knowledge, in order to build ICT tools based on open data which can really support farmers in their daily work. In order to do that, data scientists of our project did a lot of work in building a data infrastructure which can be useful for the specific context. The specific context is that in Capsella we are not working in general with agriculture, but we are working in a specific domain which I could summarize with biodiversity-based agriculture. With this, I mean all the stakeholders in the food chain that work for minimizing the use of external inputs in agriculture. For doing this, they try to apply knowledge from ecology to the agriculture sector. This can be summarized in the agroecology concept, which is a practice for many farmers all over the world, mostly smallholder farmers, that daily they try to mimic nature, to exploit biodiversity in order to minimize the external inputs that they need for producing food. It is also a movement of a lot of citizens around the world that care about the sustainability, both from the environmental but also from the society point of view. And it is also science of many agronomists that try to develop technologies that actually suit to this type of agriculture. Not only of agronomists, but as I show here, also of data scientists in this case, that are trying to build a data infrastructure that is worked for this type of agriculture. So they have implemented a platform for handling data, analyzing them, and providing all sort of services on which then we could build the services that are then helpful for the farmers. So we started from the agriculture sector. We defined our system in the biodiversity-based agriculture, and our aim was to use open data to support farmers. Here I have a first example to show how the Capsella data infrastructure can actually support farmers. And it is a case in which Twitter data were harvested in our platform, and they were analyzed in order to, with a sentiment analysis, in order to see, for example, what in European cities, this map is actually from Rome, how often and what is the opinion of citizens about food in general, but in this case it's about organic food, having an idea of how often, where people speak of organic food and if their idea of that is positive or negative can be very important to support the promotion of healthy food. But coming back to the real challenges, when we really want to build services that help the stakeholders, the first thing that we need is the actual stakeholders. Here you see pictures of farmers from Italy and Greece. Those are two associations of farmers that are committed to organic agriculture and to promote sustainable food production. The way we interacted with them in this project in order to produce something with them and not something for them was, first of all, in different meetings and with different communication tools to listen to what they have to say and to understand what's their world. It's what here I say, it's a rich picture. Knowing their world without speaking of data, seeing what their actual issues every day are. From that, the interaction between the different people in the project, so the agronomists, the farmers, the data scientists, allowed to let emerge the issues which could actually be addressed through data science. And after that, what we did with the same people was to go down to simple problems which could be actually addressed in the timeline of a project. And in this way, we decided with the farmers to focus on the topic of soil health. This because the conditions of the soil, it's really a priority for having a sustainable farming system. And also because the mainstream way of looking at that, it's about chemical fertility. So I look how much my plants need and I plan how much nutrients I have to give to the soil. Another way of looking at that is looking at the soil as complex and alive ecosystems on which there is a balance of different sides, the biological, the physical, as well as the chemical. And from this balance, it's what brings to the balance that allows for a long-term production without exploiting the fertility of the soil. In order, this is the concept those farmers have in mind. In their daily life, what they need to do is monitor how actually the soil is doing. And for doing that, of course, you have the soil analysis, but those are expensive and those are done every 5-10 years. Farmers need to know in between what's going on. What they usually do is going to the field, digging out some soil and looking at that. If you do that in a planned way with a standardized protocol, which is called spade test, this gives a lot of good information. How we have supported them is by building a platform, soilhealth.capsella.eu, with a list of functions that actually support farmers in taking care of the health of their soils. First function that we have is a spade test application, with which the farmers can go to the field, follow a standardized protocol, and record their observation and share those observations on our platform. That's actually it's knowledge from the farmers becoming open data for the other farmers or for the wide public. And this is very useful for the farmers for recording and keeping track, but also for new farmers or farmers which are not used to look at this way to their soil to get aware about that. So that is the side of data from farmers becoming open. The other side is supporting the knowledge of farmers with open data. And the other function on our portal is about soil organic matter dynamics. It's soil organic matter, it's very fundamental for the fertility of soil, and keeping track on how this changes according to the practices, it's fundamental for farmers. The way we can support it is by taking climatic and soil data from open data repositories, running simplified models on soil organic matter, and coupling it with the information that we get on the specific site from the farmers to give very simple indications. So we say, if you keep doing this type of organic fertilization for the next 10 years, the soil organic matter in your soil is going to increase, to decrease, or to stay stable. And that's a simple information, but that helps very much the farmers in reflecting on the long-term effect of the agronomic practices that they do today. And actually, this willingness to put together, to make data from the farmers become open and to provide support to the farmers with open data, it's sort of integrated in our platform because, for example, we have on one side the possibility to upload information on the spade test done on your site, but on the platform you can also look at the maps from the European Union soil initiative and see at a larger scale the information, and that's all information that helps the farmer to reflect on the more specific conditions on his site. So actually the core idea that we are trying to put forward with this project is that what actually mostly benefits farmers is when we are not going to give a decision support system that puts inside some data, makes some analysis and says, do that. That farmers don't really like. They like to see that their knowledge can be made stronger, that this decision making can be made more with more information on the back, thanks to open data, and that's what we are trying to do in the project. I actually would have now a small 3 minutes video that summarizes this activity.
As a farmer, there are probably a few questions you ask yourself every day. What will the weather be like? Is it going to rain? How are the crops doing? Are there any pests or diseases causing trouble around? But do you ask yourself often enough, how is your soil doing? Farmers from the Kupsala community are asking this question every day. We are here to support you in finding the answers about the health of your soil. We are building a tool allowing self-assessment of soil health across Europe. Farmers will now be able to share their findings, learn from each other, and seek further advice. Sustainable farming isn't just a fashion. Sustainability is key to the future of our planet. The soil is a complex living ecosystem, important for plants and animals which support agricultural production. It's also a resource which cannot be renewed easily. Soil health depends in equal parts on its chemical, physical, and biological fertility. These elements, when out of balance, can lead to soil health degradation. On a global scale, unhealthy soils not only cause stunted crop growth, but have a negative impact on natural ecosystems, climate, agriculture, and human health. Around the world, soil is increasingly degrading. Keeping it in good health is a major goal of sustainability. After all, healthy soils produce healthy crops and preserve natural resources. Here's how you can monitor the health of your soil. The spade test is a widely used, qualitative method for monitoring soil health. It will give you knowledge on the fertility conditions of your soil and the effects of the mechanical operations on its structure. For performing the spade test, you will need a digging spade or fork, a knife to clean the surface of the sample, a white tray to better visualize the sample. The spray test will also give you an idea of what should be improved in crop fertilization or other agronomic practices. To farmer communities, it is important to have simple tools to monitor soil health. This is why we have created the CupSeller application, available for desktop and mobile devices. It is intuitive and will guide you through every step of the spade test. The CupSeller application makes recording your observations easy. Before taking a soil sample, first have a look around the area. Can you notice any signs of erosion, waterlogging, or surface crusting? Take a soil sample. Make sure it's the right size. Take a record of how many different layers are visible in the sample and how thick is each one of them. Observe soil compaction and the shape of soil aggregates. Can you notice any residues? What type are they? Assess the sample's color and smell. And last but not least, check for the soil biodiversity and give a grade from 1 to 5 to each soil layer. The data you've gathered will be summarized for easy consultation. Monitoring your soil health and sharing your data will make it possible to understand soil changes across Europe, prompt action, and help ensure that future generations will enjoy growing healthy crops. Download the CupSeller application for free and start monitoring your soil health today.
And the stakeholders and the way to discuss with them about data and make them aware of them. So